Soumeet's drawn up some charts to show why is it that the fourth quarter may turn out to be a good quarter. Soumeet, good morning.
Good morning, Yudhich. So mainly it will be because of the rising gross marketing margins. You can clearly see in this chart in the last quarter, that is the third quarter of financial year 2018, how the gross marketing margins were falling. Right from October, it came down to its lowest point in December when the gross marketing margin earned on sale of every litre of petrol and diesel fell to around 1.2 rupees per litre and 1.3 rupees per litre. But now in this quarter, that is the fourth quarter, that is from Jan, Feb and so far as of now in March, the gross marketing margin earned on sale of every litre of petrol and diesel has been rising. In Jan, it rose to around 2.5 and 2.6 rupees per litre and now in March, it's at 9-month high. Now, it is at around 3.3 rupees per litre and 3.6, that was the level that we saw in the last July 2017. Now, this rise in marketing margin could largely be attributable to the recent fall in the crude prices, but the surge in the retail and retail fuel prices. As you can see here, in the fourth quarter of financial year 2018, year to date, Brent crude has fallen around 2%, while your retail petrol and diesel prices have increased by 4% and 6%. Now, this compared to the last quarter, where the Brent crude has increased 16%, but your petrol and diesel prices were largely unchanged. So this change now in the fourth quarter is giving the oil marketing companies a bit more room to increase their gross marketing margins, which will also cover up for the losses that the companies did in the last quarter. So this fall in Brent crude prices versus the rise in retail petrol and diesel prices is leading to an increase in the gross marketing margins of the oil marketing companies. Now if you see, though Brent crude has come off a bit from its recent high, but compared to the last quarter, the average Brent crude prices are still higher. Now in the fourth quarter, that is year to date, the Brent crude is average around $67.24 per barrel versus $61.4 per barrel reported by the Brent crude that averaged in the last quarter. Now if you see, generally when the Brent crude is on an average higher compared to the last quarter, the oil marketing companies have reported an inventory gain. You can see in the first quarter of financial year 2018, when the Brent crude fell by around 7% compared to the last quarter, the three oil marketing companies, that is Indian Oil Corporation, Bharat Petroleum and HPCL, reported a cumulative inventory loss of close to 6,200 crore rupees. In the second quarter, when it increased to $52.1 per barrel, they reported an inventory gain of close to 2,500 crore. And similarly, in the last quarter, when the Brent crude averaged at around $61.4 per barrel, they reported an inventory gain of more than 9,000 crore rupees. Now, in this quarter so far, the Brent crude has averaged at around $67.2 per barrel. So we can expect an inventory gain from the oil marketing companies. Lastly, the gross refining margin, now that has been stable at $6.9 per barrel. Now this is a bit off compared to the last quarter where it was around $7.2 per barrel. But if you see the month-wise data, it has been on an increasing trend. In January, it came at around $6.2 per barrel. In February, it was around $7.5 per barrel. And so far in the month of March, it has averaged around $7.9 per barrel. Now a higher gross refining margin means that the oil marketing has been earning more on every barrel of oil that it has been processing. So these are the three factors that are working in favor of the oil marketing companies in the fourth quarter so far in the financial year 2018.
Could there be a risk to these come Karnataka elections, Soumeet?
Yeah, we have seen in the past trends, whenever there have been state elections, the rise in retail fuel and petrol prices have not been that rising. So maybe there could be a risk in the upcoming elections also.
But by then, the quarter four would have been over.
So quarter four Q1 could be a risk that we can see. Likely we saw in the last quarter, that was in the Q3, where all the oil marketing companies also saw a fall in their marketing EBITDA compared to the last quarter because of the restricted rise in retail fuel and prices.
Well, interesting analysis there, and maybe one reason why the OMC stood out in trade yesterday.
Yeah.
Soumeet, thanks for putting that into perspective. I much appreciate that. Well, so that's the sum and substance of the things that we've noticed today.